adult education ingredient. My name is Rosalia Wong. Guess what I'm going to bring you today? Today the topic is called How Do You Conduct the Education Planning Program? Okay, let's get started. So for other suggestions and advices, you can put me to the links in the description section below so I will give you awesome insights into what you need to know for your profession and your organization. So now let's get back into the topic. So our interest in planning adult education are related to which program constructed and the power belongs to whose interest that should be represented. The study and research was done by Wilson and Cervero in 1996. Since planners are responsible for planning the programs, they should know how to put forward their interests. Planners of the education program must understand that they are not the free agents able to translate their interests directly into the purposes, the contents, and the format of the programs. Planners of the education program also must understand that they may encounter people who has a complete conflict with their interests. Planners of the education program also must know that therefore they need power of negotiation and the skill of negotiation as a tribe. Planners of the education program also know that if the actual form and content of the programs depend on the interests of those who construct them, then the central ethical question becomes whose interests will planners represent? And the central political question becomes how will the planners negotiate those interests? So the planners of the education program also must understand that they should recognize these are the people whose interests affect their planning of educational programs. For example, the teachers, the learners, the other planners, also the institutional leaders and the affected public. So if you like the content, remember to put a thumbs up and share it with a friend. And actually I have another similar video which I have made previously, and it's called The Power and Interest in Program Planning and Negotiation. It's very similar to the topic I'm talking about today, so you can find the link from the above. One question: why is program planning negotiable? So negotiation is the central form of action because the program always resulted in the ideas of the five groups of people mentioned before. Remember, the teachers, the learners, the entrepreneurs, the institutional leaders, and also the affected public, and also their interests as well. So negotiation is needed. And program planning needs a bargain and discusses with views to reach an agreement. Remember, all planners experience the central concept, power, interest, negotiation, and also responsibility. So all planners love to see their work done. And how? So please do not neglect the confront and negotiate issues with people, especially the five categories of the people that I just mentioned above. For example, if they call, think whether you should ignore the call or is it crucial? If confronted and talk about issues and problems, consider whether the issues and questions should be ignored or require immediate attention. Very important. Actually, I think the topic today is not only just related to refer to the adult continuing education planning practice, it also refers to all profession. I think perhaps the ideas are the same, but the concepts might be different. So all profession can refer to it, and I hope that this topic you will find it useful and good for your reference. And thank you for listening today and tuning in. And also, you can subscribe to my channel by hitting the button so you will not miss anything, because I bring you new ingredients, new topic, and new insights every Monday and Thursday. And for awesome suggestions and advices, you can book me through the links in the description section below. So I will give you awesome insights into what you need to know for your profession and your organization. Finally, thank you very much for tuning in today. Be with me until next time, and goodbye.